Welcome to another Rebel University video tutorial. This video will cover all the basics for creating orders, closing out orders for payments, and more. As with all of our tutorials, you can jump ahead to any topic that is most important to you. All of our videos have a table of contents listed below, or you can use the time bar to skip ahead to a desired section. Before we begin, if you haven't already, please review the point of sale overview tutorial linked below. This video assumes you've already watched that tutorial and have a basic understanding of the dashboard on the point of sale. Additionally, for demonstration purposes here, we'll be using the New Order tab to create our orders. However, if you are a table service restaurant, you will primarily use the Tables tab on the point of sale to create new orders. This is covered in a separate tutorial linked below. Before we create an order, let's put the point of sale in training mode. This will prevent any orders that we make from accumulating in your system and affecting your sales data. To turn training mode on, navigate to Settings and tap Training Mode. Tap the slider on the right to turn it on. Once training mode is activated, a red bar will display across the top. Tap the dashboard icon at the bottom left to return to the dashboard. Next, I'll select New Order to see all the options that appear on the order screen. First, once an order is created, it will be assigned a unique order number at the top left. Tap on the order number to open the order details screen. Here, you can add a customer to the order, change the dining option, enter a pickup time, add order notes, and even edit discounts and service fees. Tap Done to leave the details screen and return to the order. Next, we have the orders icon, which is covered in greater detail on the point of sale overview video. However, this information can also be accessed from any order. Search for an order here or view all orders, open orders, or today's orders. The ellipses icon allows you to access more details and preferences. The question mark icon further explains some of the items you see on the screen. The diagonal arrow allows you to see the menu in full screen mode. To return to split screen, tap the arrow again. The magnifying glass allows you to search for products. Between the search option and the ability to scan items by barcode or by navigating your menu, you can locate your products very easily. The person icon allows you to attach a customer to the order from the CRM. The CRM is covered in detail in a separate tutorial, so be sure to check that out if you have any questions. Also, from the CRM, you can choose the Call Names tab to add a call name to the order. Just type in the name or scroll and tap on an existing call name. Tap Add to add the call name to the order. The ellipses icon allows you to see additional order actions, such as increasing the quantity of an item, adding a service fee, or adding a discount. The next section is the order section. As we select items from our menu on the right or scan barcodes, those items will begin to appear on the left. If your item has a modifier, the modifier screen will come up automatically. Here you can select the appropriate modifiers. After your modifiers have been selected, tap Add to Order. If you need to adjust an item, tap on the item in the order and an additional screen will appear. The options here may vary based on the type of business you have as well as your settings. But notice, I can adjust modifiers, the quantity, and more. So if I need to adjust my modifiers after I've added them to an order, when I click that option, the modifier window reappears for me to make changes. Below the order, you'll see additional options for the order status. Depending on your settings, you can either tap Cancel, Hold, or Send. Cancel can be used if a customer changes their mind and doesn't want to place an order. It will cancel the entire order. If you would like to remove a certain item from the order without canceling the whole thing, you can swipe left on the item and then tap delete. The hold option allows you to temporarily hold the order for a customer. Perhaps a customer forgot their wallet in their car and you have a line of customers. You can hold their order so the other customers don't have to wait. Return to the original customer's order using the Orders tab at the top and then complete the payment. If you have items attached to your kitchen printer or kitchen display screen, Send Order will push those items to that assigned location. The items will turn gray once they are sent. To edit the entire order, use the Quick Actions icons at the bottom of the order. These buttons are customizable, so you may see different options on your screen. For full details on customizing your point of sale, please review that article linked below. A few common options that you'll see here include a quantity button, which allows you to set a quantity for a product. Enter the quantity first and then add the item. The Add Extra Item icon allows you to create a one-time use item. In this box, the required fields are the name and price. You may choose to enter other details about the product as well, then tap Create. Remember, this is just a one-time use item. If you would like to save it to your inventory, you can tap Save to Server, then select Create. Next is Discount Order. If you created an order discount in the Management Console, you can select it from the list here. If you do not have an order discount set up, you can create it by clicking Manual. Enter the value, type, and reason for the discount. Remember, this button will discount the entire order. Service fee is a feature that allows either a percentage or flat fee to be added to the entire order. You may select a service fee previously set up in the Management Console, but you also have the option to create a manual service fee here. If you haven't completed payment, you can use the Print Guest Check icon to print a summary of all ordered items. If your establishment uses barcodes, use the Enter Barcode button to manually type in or scan an item's barcode. Open Cash Drawer allows you to open the cash drawer and access the till without completing a transaction. Remove Tax gives you the ability to remove the tax from the entire order. Once removed, the button changes to Add Tax so you can add tax back to an order. Dining option allows you to indicate the dining selection for the order. These options are customizable in the Management Console. When you are ready to close out the order, tap the Pay button and proceed with the payment. On the left, we see some of the order details, including any discounts, tax, gratuity, etc. The total balance due appears in red. At the bottom left are additional options to print a gift receipt, email a receipt, reprint the receipt, refund payments, or add rewards. On the right, above the pen pad, is the payment amount. Note, the total balance due shows by default. This means if I select cash as my payment option, the system will process the cash payment for the exact order amount. It's important to adjust this based on the cash provided by the customer so that the system calculates the change due. If the amount is incorrect, tap the C button to clear. Then enter the correct amount using one of the quick dollar amounts or manually type in the tender provided. If a customer wants to use another method of payment, choose from one of the other options below the pin pad. The payment options that appear here are customizable in your Management Console. For more information on this, please view our article, Customizing Order, Payment, and Action Buttons, linked below. If I process this transaction as cash, once the transaction is complete, the cash drawer will open. Under Change, you will also see the amount due back listed in red. Depending on your setting, you may or may not need to tap Done in order to finalize and close the transaction. If you process the order as a credit transaction for the full balance due, select credit. Then you'll be prompted to swipe a credit card on the card reader. And just like that, you've created an order and processed a payment. We hope you found this tutorial helpful and were able to follow along to complete the necessary steps. If you have additional questions, please visit the related knowledge base articles and tutorials linked below. Thank you for watching another Revel University video tutorial.